right now I'm on my way to meet Alex. I think my car's coming as well, if I'm not mistaken. But I know for sure I'm going to meet Alex. We're going to be viewing some apartments together, because I believe they're looking to move as well. And yeah, once we go and view these apartments, hopefully I can find something that I like. This is number two. I like the view here from this balcony more, I'll be real. This is a new apartment, by the way. As you can see, it's good stuff. Still viewing.
Here we are. We have collected the keys for a brand new 3-bedroom apartment in downtown Dubai.
Welcome back to the channel, guys. It is your boy, Yarimi. I am here with the long-awaited penthouse tour video in Dubai. Yes, you heard it correctly, it's finally here. Niggas see the crib and ask, who did I steal from? Price tags on making the world feel some. They don't have enough to satisfy a real one. Maverick Carter couldn't even get the deal done. I can finally show you guys what I've been getting up to, how I've been designing this house from scratch without any help. It's the interior designer Yarimi. I'm gonna start speaking about types of art that you've never seen. I'm not about to get into some crazy explanations, but before I get into all of that, I just want to let you guys know, man, this has always been a dream of mine to move to Dubai. And before trading, before any of my entrepreneurial endeavors, I always enjoyed the feel this country gives me. Now, I grew up not having money, right? My sisters actually worked normal jobs and they would save whatever money they had to try their best to bring me and my family on holidays. One of them being Dubai. We stayed in a place called Al Karama, Golden Sands Hotel, apartment hotel, very, very, very long ago, and it was very, very cheap. We stayed there, and at that time, it wasn't nothing to do with money. It wasn't anything to do with how close are we to the Burj Khalifa. It was more so just the experience, you know? We're out of London, it's a new country, it's a new place. Let's just enjoy it. And I want to begin this video by saying, if you are in a negative environment in your life, moving away sometimes does make a way. Because if it wasn't for my sisters saving up the money that they had to pay for me to come to Dubai with them many, many years ago, I wouldn't have had the aspiration or motivation to make Dubai on my vision board, you know? So Dubai wouldn't have been in the picture if they didn't expose me to it. And I stand here before you today having achieved that goal of moving to Dubai. And when I achieved my first goal of living in a penthouse in Canary Wharf, the financial district of the entire world after Wall Street, I felt very accomplished, okay? And it's not a situation of I'm now searching for more, but when I moved to the penthouse in Canary Wharf, I said, I'm not gonna be here for long. My next dream location is Dubai. And I wanna play the clip right now for you.
Yeah, this is one of my short-term goals completed. So my long-term goal is to move to Dubai.
So yeah, there you have it. You heard the conviction in my voice that I'm going to achieve this goal. And this is not out of arrogance, or this is not out of a prideful intention. No, this is to simply tell you guys that I'm no different to you. I'm a human being. You are a human being. I bleed. You bleed. You work. I work. Our channels of energy when it comes to work may be directed in different places. So as an outcome of where we direct our energy, two people end up living two different lives. And it's not too late if you feel like you've been giving energy in the wrong places. You can always make a change to that. I wanted to start off this video with a positive message so that it doesn't look like I'm just bragging or flexing, guys. You guys have witnessed my journey from day one when I had nothing, when I had minus £6 in my bank account. I was poor, I was broke, I was walking in the rain to work. I was eating whatever I could on my lunch break because I didn't want to ask anyone for money. You know my story, you've seen the shorts, you've seen the TikToks time and time again. I'm not here to repeat myself, I'm here to let you guys know, Yarimi, the guy you see in front of this camera right now is no different to you. Forget trading, forget whatever I've got going on. Whatever you want to make happen in your life, you can make it happen. It just takes a lot of grit, resilience, determination, and understanding that the word no does not exist in our vocabulary when it comes to naysayers or people who want to scrutinize and cherry pick every single thing they want to criticize us on. No. That is a type of bulletproof mindset you need in order for you to succeed. Without further ado, let's begin the house tour. Let's walk back, man. Let's go. Okay, so first and foremost, I've started off with a dark vibe. Yes, everything is dark. Why? I'm a person who, as much as I'm very extroverted in my ways, I'm actually very much introverted once I've had my fair share of being extroverted for the day. So I've decided to go with, anyways, what relevance does that have? The relevance that has is I like a dark theme. I like a dark vibe when I'm home after, you know, being out, working, so on and so forth. I just want to chill in a place that I feel like I don't want to leave. And that's exactly why I've gone above and beyond to make this place my den. I made this my man cave so that I have to have a very good enough of an excuse to leave this place, okay? And I'm sort of reliving my childhood dreams, everything I didn't have when I was younger. I'm now able to have it here in my house. So first and foremost, I've decided to go with black wallpaper throughout the entire house. Black with hints of gray accents, just to complement further contrast that I want to be putting around the entire house, whether that be pillows, whether that be carpet, so on and so forth, okay? Now, as you can see as well, I've got carpets on the floor. Now, this is absolutely unorthodox if you are living in Dubai, but the reason I actually decided to put carpets instead of leaving hardwood flooring or tiles is simply to, I don't know, ship that same homely feeling I have in London to Dubai. Because one thing I actually don't like about Dubai is if all of their apartments come with hard flooring, tiles, and me, I'm a granddad at a very young age. I'm 25 years old, but these knees right here, these knees got some knockers on them. Like whenever I walk around on hard flooring, my knees just start to ache, and I've got a condition, not a condition, but I've got something called a bow leg. When I was younger, I used to go to the park and take free kicks. I used to practice my David Beckham curve shots. So I used to plant my left foot on the ball like this, distribute all my body weight onto my left foot, and try and hit the ball at a 90 degree angle. And as a result of that, my left knee slightly bent. So now that whenever I'm standing still, I'm gonna let you guys in on a little secret. You will never actually catch me standing straight for longer than like 30 seconds. I'll always bend to one side because of the problem I have in my knee. That's why I chose carpet over hard flooring, simply because of the vibe that it gives in the house, and it just allows me to feel at home. But let's come here. This is actually the main entrance. This is the main entrance, but I wanna show you guys something. You see this thing outside right here? That right there? Yep. That is a sofa. And unfortunately, well, not unfortunately, but being the picky person I am, I changed sofas 3 times in this penthouse. I changed it 3 times simply because I'm just very picky. The first one looked amazing, but then as I began to sit on it, I realized this is just for the aesthetics. It's actually not a comfortable sofa, and it doesn't accommodate for more than like 2-3 people. That was not good. Then I got a bigger one, like an L-shaped type of checkered sofa, all black. Then I said, why am I talking about the sofa? Let's go over there. Then I'm gonna talk to you about the sofa. But anyways, this is just a regular toilet for guests, okay? Nothing special about that. I'm not about to give you a Shakespearean breakdown on where the toilet seat was imported from. Where should we start from, Shion? Living room to last, right?
I think we need the best for last.
Right? Come. Let's start with here. This is just some storage space. This is a bathroom, actually. So here you have your shower, toilet, sink. And as you know me, you never know who might come around. So always have these on deck for the boys. Okay, follow me. Now next up, this is where the video started. This is actually my bedroom. Welcome to the bedroom. Nothing special here. Let's begin over here. This is a wardrobe I have right here. And as we can see, this is my smart clothes section, pretty much. Blazers, shirts, jumpers, turtlenecks, smart shoes, the whole shebang. Same thing going on over here. This is more so my thobes, short sleeve shirts, all that good stuff. Same thing over here. And now step into the bathroom. Nothing special other than not even half of my perfume collection. So this is literally where it goes down. My favorite, 1, 2, Vanilla Fatale. If you know about Vanilla, you probably don't know about Vanilla Fatale. You probably only know about Tobacco Vanilla, or, you know what I mean? You probably only know about this regular stuff right here, okay? Those three right now are my favorite. Then you got these are my favorite as well. Side Effect, then you got By the Fire by Mason Margiela. What else have we got here? Yeah, there's a bunch of stuff. Maybe I'll make a whole separate perfume collection video when the rest of my perfume comes from London. Now, if you know me, you would know I'm a man that likes to wear caps, especially when my hair's growing out. So this is the Great Wall of China, man. And now this is my bedroom. Nothing fancy, just a nice little bed. Yep, nice little bed. TV here, feel like a king. Okay, come, let's go. Now for the next room. This is a room I created for myself to let my inner child out. And also to accommodate for when guests come to my house and we wanna indulge in some extracurricular activities. No diddy. I remember the suffering of what it feels like to wait around when you have to play FIFA and lose and you have to wait all the way till your turn. So I created this room here as literally just like a lad's room. It is a gaming room slash studio slash where I do some audio recordings. I'm currently recording an audiobook for those who didn't know. So this is what this is gonna come in very handy for. So should I play them a snippet?
Yeah, why not?
Should I play them a snippet? Yeah. But yeah, before I play the snippet, nice little sofa here. Nice little canvas. This was actually gifted to me by Swaggy. I got an L-shaped sofa here, blue just to contrast the theme of the house. There's a lot of black. There is blue as well. And if you come around this way and show them, two TV screens right there, okay? A double TV screen here. And then this is where engineer Yarimi gets a crack. For those of you who don't know, I actually worked in a studio, and when I was in year 10, I officially done work experience there. You guys might be thinking, bro, how many places has this guy worked? Yeah, I worked in a lot of places, okay? But let's take a look at this now, very, 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 very quickly. Yeah, so the reason I mentioned the fact that I used to work is I literally mix, master, I know how to do all of that stuff. So when you hear anything vocal related, that's literally me mixing it. So now let me play you guys a snippet.
Coming from North London, I went to nursery and primary school in Enfield, secondary school in Edmonton, religious studies in Tottenham and 4th Street, youth club in Palmer's Green, and I would get my regular haircuts in Turnpike Lane. My dream was to always move out of the country, but I knew it would take a series of steps and it must be calculated, so.
It sounds crazy. It sounds crazy, I know. Cliffhangers. Okay, so yeah, that will be coming out whenever I decide it comes out. I forgot to mention, this is a mirror that I handpicked literally because I felt like it would suit the aesthetic of the entire house. Some suede sort of design, loved it, it looks different. Anything that looks different I'm interested in, to be completely honest with you. Now, before we enter the living room, this is a piece of artwork I created myself on Photoshop. I designed this here. The world says in a boastful manner, be careful of my deceptions and my lies. Do not let my false happiness deceive you, for my words will make you laugh, but my actions will make you cry. هِيَ الدُّنْيَا تَقُولُ بِمِلْءِ فِيهَا هَذَارِي هَذَارِي مِنْ بَطْشِي وَفَتْكِي فَلَا يَغُرُّكُمْ مِنِّي إِبْتِسَامٌ فَقَوْلِي مُضْحِكٌ وَالْفِعْلُ مُبْكِي. Don't get too lost in the sauce. Whenever you are on a path of attaining large sums of riches or you're elevating in life, don't let it get to your head, don't let it get to your heart, and most definitely don't let it affect how you are as an individual, because it could be a trap for you to now indulge heavily in this type of lifestyle when its entire purpose was to eventually make you cry. Next up is the office. Welcome to the place where I catch those entries, where I actually also explore my other entrepreneurial endeavors. Come through, come through. Yes, so this is the office. This is the theme I've decided to go with once again, all black and white. And fun fact about this little piece of a sofa I'm sitting on right now, this was actually the old sofa that was outside that you saw earlier, but I had to split it in half. I said to myself, you know what? Instead of taking a full loss on this, let me just take a 50% loss and I can use this for my office, which turned out absolutely amazing. So yeah, this sofa worked out perfectly in the office. This is my desk. I don't know how many inches this monitor is, but all I know is that it can curve. Like, I can curve it like this, I can make it straight, or I can curve it like this, and it looks absolutely ridiculous. iPad here for whenever I want to sketch, like trading stuff, and my laptop here for some work. I just connect my laptop to the monitor with a USB type C cable. This is where I've got my other endeavors here without getting into too much detail with that stuff. Whiteboards, these are my personal goals, so this is what I have to do every single day. Whiteboard over there is just for my personal goals, mainly goals that are gonna elevate me, elevate who I am and where I'm headed. Right here you have a brand that is going to take over the cosmetics industry very, very, very soon. In Naya body, we have rosehip oil, we have jojoba oil, imported from South America, but we're gonna get into detail about that very, very, very soon. But for now, go follow the Instagram page and we will update you on there shortly. So yeah, this is where I do my market breakdown Zoom calls. This is where I trade. So yeah, this is where I pretty much get cracking every single day, whether that be trading, whether that be other businesses I'm trying to grow. This is where I'm located when it comes to starting all business. And now this is where you are welcomed to the darkness. Yarimi. Welcome to the living room. Amazing stuff. As you can see, we've gone with the all black Batman theme. This is where I sit down and I plan my takeover, guys. This is where I plan the takeover. Yarimi University is here to take over. And yeah, let's get into it. So first and foremost here, as soon as you walk in, you are welcomed by a lovely dining table. Okay, if you come close, this dining table spins around, and this is very accommodating in terms of when you want something on the table, you don't actually have to reach all the way across the table to get it. You just have to spin the table and it will come to you. Fun fact, these chairs right here were actually like lounge sort of chairs. And I told them, guys, can you sort of customize this? And I want you guys to raise it so that I can use it for a dining table. And Dubai being Dubai, these were totally different colors, by the way. I told them, can you make it black? They said, okay, we're gonna have to try. We'll make it black for you. And I told them, raise the seating so that when someone sits down to eat food right here, they can rest their elbows, they can rest their arms on the table and have a comfortable feel. Likewise, I told them to raise the armrest here so that when someone wants to sit down, they can simply rest their arms like so. And also when it comes to the type of cutlery plates I chose, I've decided to maintain the theme of black, royal blue, navy. So I found these glasses and I absolutely love them. I had to go and grab them straight away. And I kind of saw these by chance, like the way I saw them wasn't planned. I was actually leaving the mall when I saw these. Okay, we got some nice mugs. As you know, I'm a tea drinker, I love tea. So we have to drink tea in style now, and we have to drink tea in synchronization with the colors that we got going on, man. Okay, regular bowl, I think this is from IKEA. Then this I got from like an Arab shop, and then this I also got from an Arab shop as well. Perfect.
Is that the rose that never runs out?
Oh yes, this is also a rose that never dies. So what I did with this, I actually got a regular bowl. Okay, I got a bowl and I put the rose inside the bowl. It just adds a little, I don't know what it does, but it just adds a little vibe to it. So this is a rose that doesn't die. Well, it dies after a very long time. The chemicals in the rose are actually preserved. So yeah, it doesn't really die like that. I think it dies after like 6 years or 5 years, if I'm not mistaken. And then over here, we have a nice keyboard, as you know. I used to indulge in some extracurricular activities when I was younger. We're not going to speak about that here, but we can give them a little sample. Thank you. And that's that. Okay, so now you have the kitchen. So if you come around to the kitchen. Oh, before the kitchen, a poster here that means a lot to me. Every righteous person has a past and every sinner has a future. So come around to the kitchen now. Same thing with the kitchen. We've gone for dark vibes, dark themes. Come through. Around here, you actually have a secret room. And the secret room just so happens to be a maid's room, okay? But I've obviously turned this maid's room into just a single sleeping bed type of thing. And what's actually amazing about this is the fact that it's actually got a toilet as well. Come around. Here we have it. It's simple, it's nice, it's small. It's got a shower, okay? It's got a shower, sink, toilet. And this is just extra room now when people want to come and stay over at my house. By the way, the sofa you saw in the gaming room actually turns into a sofa bed. So it turns into an actual bed. It can actually fit two people as well. Now, we've completed the kitchen, the maid's room, the piano, the dining table. Let's go ahead and take a look at this. This is like an Ottoman Turkish vibe that I got, you know, where from Yemen, so we drink a lot of gahwa. I've grown to love it over the last year. I think it's because I'm 25, turning 26 now. I'm starting to mature. I'm starting to say no sugar, please. You know, and that's very concerning because I'm a man who loves sugar. So this is basically a tray we can serve guests. And me being the person I am, I always have guests over my house. So now here, this is what we want to speak about, guys. Before we get into it, so this is a chair that I also custom made. I custom made this chair. I told him to make it black and change the shape of it. So this is a nice custom made chair right here. Nothing special, a nice circular table from IKEA. My bad, what makes this special actually, you can see at the bottom of it is marble. Got this to match the dining table that also has a marble theme going on here. And so yeah, the sofa. I changed the sofa 3 times and it's been the best decision I ever made because when I saw the sofa, it was beige, it was a different material, and I told them, I want you guys to make this black, no surprise. Make it black, add extra cotton in there, and also increase the dimensions of the sofa by 10 centimeters extra, so that when I'm sat here, my knees are covered, okay? My knees are covered because the sofa was actually shorter. And if I remove all these pillows, it literally comes up to beyond my knee, which I love. This right here is an absolute bed, okay? The term sofa isn't enough for this. It's a bed, it's so comfortable. I can literally sit here and fall asleep. I fell asleep here like 4 times so far. It's just great, great, great stuff. I wanna fall asleep now. But whilst I'm here, I'm gonna use this time to lay down as an excuse to explain this piece of artwork here. So I didn't make this artwork, someone else actually made it, but I blurred out the eyes and I put balance in between simply because in this life, you have to have balance. You have to know when to become a lion, when to be a leader, when to be strict, but at the same time, have a soft side too that's caring, merciful, and understanding. Hence, half lion, half flower, you know? So that's that. And then over here we have some more snacks for the guests, whoever comes. Obviously, this is where the tea and the gahwa coffee, Arabic coffee goes down. We have this called ma'mul in Arabic here. We have some dates and we have some pistachio and almond nuts that I absolutely ran out. We ran through them. Let me have some more right now as well. And then, yeah, I got these electric candles from Home Center in Dubai Hills Mall. Nice vibes here. I got these simply because of the marble as well. There was quite some spacing over here across the TV, so I wanted to fill that up with something that wouldn't take up too much room. Something that would be nice and subtle. So I decided to go for this stand and I put a candle on top of it. It didn't actually come with a candle, they come separate. But when you have the creativity in the mind, anything can happen, man. Okay, let me actually turn these on now. Okay, boom. If you're standing back there, I want to introduce them to the fireplace. Amazing, amazing, amazing fireplace. So this fireplace is actually electronic. What that means is I can change colors. So if I want to go for the classic look, I can have a nice little classic look. Something funky, something funky. Okay, blue, blue, orange. This is a bit more fiery, a bit more natural colors. Purple. What else we have? And turquoise and yellow, I think. We also have white. I like white. But overall, we keep the blue theme because Yarimi University, the color is blue. And I'm not gonna go ahead and say that's the end because it isn't. So this side table here, I got simply because, again, I like to drink a lot of tea. So when I'm having tea, I like to bring this around the other side, put my cup of tea on here. But right now we have bukhur that's on here, and I forgot to light it up, but it's okay. Because I lit it up 2 days in a row, and the house still smells of it. The curtains, amazing curtains. So when it comes to the curtains, I decided to go for double layers. I wanted to go for black, but too much black will literally make the entire house way too dark, and it does not need to be any darker. So I decided to go for black being the primary curtain that's in front, and blue being the secondary color that is at the back. And I think I've done an amazing job with this, I'll be honest with you, man. The colors complement each other very, 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 very well. Quickly, I want to show you guys the chandeliers. Yes, chandeliers. Okay, let's take a look at those chandeliers. Here we have the chandeliers. You can go for a warm look, go for a cold look. Okay, cold, mix, or warm look. I like the warm look here, but let's turn it off for now. Now, it wouldn't be a Yarimi crib without a crazy view, right? So let's go, let's go, let's go. Over here, we step out into the balcony. We are welcomed by the Fountain Show. That right there is Dubai Mall. Okay, so I literally can walk to Dubai Mall. It takes me a 7-minute walk to walk to Dubai Mall, or I can literally pick up my phone and call a buggy to pick me up and take me anywhere I want across the entire road. Restaurants, hotels, the mall, wherever I want to go, anywhere I want to go, the buggy will take me there. So as you can see, we've got Dubai Mall right here, and we also have the Burj Khalifa views right there. Amazing, amazing. Probably the best location in Dubai after the fronds on the Palm, because the fronds had the crazy villas. In terms of like apartment penthouse style places, I don't think anything beats this place here. And yeah, as you can see, the Fountain Show has just finished. Okay, so let's get into the balcony. I've chosen black artificial grass, black astroturf, just for the aesthetics. Yarimi, why didn't you get green? Because I wanted black. I want to match the vibes. Two beanbags out here. If anyone wants to come, we have a heart to heart. Sit outside, drink some nice karak chai, look at the views, sit down, and just have some nice conversations. Come around this way. Got myself a nice little rocking chair, nice swing, and I can just take in the views like this. Okay, if I come around this way now, this is where I'll be doing some outdoor Zoom calls as the weather is getting better in Dubai right now. So I can do some nice outdoor Zoom calls right here and work. Nice views. If I leave this door open, the AC still hits me, so I'm okay. Not in the daytime. Daytime is crazy. Nighttime right now, the weather is amazing. I can sit out here and work. And yeah, that is pretty much it, guys. Downstairs, we actually have a cinema room. We have a big swimming pool. We have a lounge area. We have outdoor areas. We have a big, big, big gym. So I saw this nice little lamp and I thought it looked very, very cool. So I decided to go and buy this. It just adds a little bit of an extra touch. I felt as though the living room was missing some sort of light, even though we have two big chandeliers and we have a backlight over here. I wanted something that adds a little bit of a nice vibe. And that does that. It makes sense in my head. I'm not sure if it makes sense on yours, but we get there. Anyways, this is a huge, huge, huge TV. This is actually a 98-inch TV that I shipped from my apartment in Canary Wharf in London. And it actually managed to survive the cargo shipment. It didn't crack, it didn't break or anything. So that is the story behind that TV. So here, I actually chose to put some nice wood panels just to add that extra aesthetic, you know? If the entire place was wallpaper, it would just look a bit too much. But this, I feel like, adds a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful contrast to the vibes in the household. And this house was absolutely empty, by the way. I'm going to insert a clip right now. I'm going to insert a clip and show you guys how empty the house was. So I literally designed everything from scratch. And this is the final result, man. These flowers, it might look like it's just a bunch of flowers, but I actually picked these specifically, different shades of blue. We got blue roses, blue flowers, and light blue flowers. I don't know much about flowers, so I'm not gonna sit here and waffle to you guys like I do. So yeah, guys, that's pretty much been the house tour. I hope you guys are able to take some real life inspiration from this, man, because I say this time and time again, I do not come from this type of life. I don't come from this type of life. I was down bad. I was in a lot of debt. I was battling in my mind every single day. I had people pointing fingers at me, telling me you will not become anything in life. I had friends who were friends from a distance, but really and truly, they revealed their true colors later on. I had people who looked at me as if I was a maniac, always trying to start something new. I had people looking at me, acting as though they are supporting me, but then hearing about my name being mentioned in gatherings that I was not present at. This is what it takes to become successful. Prepare for the worst. Prepare for betrayal. Prepare for disloyalty. Prepare for doubters. Prepare for criticizers. Prepare for naysayers. Prepare for anonymous users commenting underneath your videos. Become that guy because you are that guy. You just don't know you are that guy. You don't. But I need you to lock in. Lock in. Take a paper and pen. Write down your goals for the next 90 days. Scrap Forex, scrap e-com, scrap everything. Focus on you. You, because if you are not upright within yourself as a human being, how the hell do you expect any endeavor of yours to become upright in life? You must become a correct person first, become a correct human being, and then everything else will follow suit. You can do this, guys. I made my first million just after I turned 23 years old. And after I made my first million, the rest kept flying in. Did I have a barrier in my mind telling me a million is unachievable? No. I always knew it was there. I say this time and time again. I was poor, but I was rich in my mind. I was mentally exhausted, but I was rich in my mind. I had zero in my bank, but I was rich in my mind. I had doubts in my corner, but I was rich in my mind. I had people telling me no, but I was rich in my mind. I was window shopping for Ferraris and McLarens, but I was rich in my mind. Your mind is the most powerful tool you have. This is no motivational speech. I am no Steve Harvey. I am no Eric Thomas. I am no motivational speaker. I am the person who probably has a similar background to you, telling you, forget me. Start any industry there is in this world. Make sure you are a correct individual. Believe in yourself. Do your parents proud, and you can make it. That's been a house tour. I'm gonna cut the video right here. Everybody, peace, love. Make sure you subscribe. I'm trying to reach 70,000 subscribers by the end of December. Can we do it? Can we make it happen? Let me know. Leave a comment and let me know. What part of the house can you see yourself being in all day long? Let me know. I've been your boy Yarimi. Take care. Peace.